The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Rejoice in this Lenten season, our opportunity to be in God's house and hear the word of the Lord. We've been focusing on God's gift of the second article of the Creed, redemption. Jesus Christ, my Lord, has redeemed me, a lost and condemned person, purchased and won me from all sin, from death, and from the power of the devil, not with gold or silver, but with his holy, precious blood, with his innocent suffering and death, that I may be his own and live under him in his kingdom and serve him in everlasting righteousness, innocentness, and blessedness, just as he has risen from the dead and lives and reigns to all eternity. This is most certainly true. Before we begin our service, bow our heads for a prayer. Dear and gracious Father, thank you for the gift of this night, the opportunity to be in your house and hear your word. Rejoice in the gift of Jesus, crucified on the cross and risen from the dead, setting us free to live as your children. For it's in Jesus' name we gather, his name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
Come, light the darkness and overcome.
Stay with us, Lord, for it is evening.
And the day is almost over.
Let your light scatter the darkness.
And then home in your church.
Joyous light of glory. The incense of our repentant prayer ascend before you, O Lord, and let your loving kindness descend on us, that with purified minds we may sing your praise with the church on earth, with the whole heavenly host, may glorify you forever.
Amen.
May be seated. The Old Testament lesson for this evening is from Isaiah, the 6th chapter. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim, each had 6 wings. With 2 he covered his face, with 2 he covered his feet, with 2 he flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The foundations of the thresholds shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin atoned for. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then he said, here am I, send me. O Lord, have mercy on us. Epistle lesson is from 1 John, the first chapter. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we have fellowship with him while we walk in the darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 13th chapter. There were some present at the very time who told Jesus about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And he answered them, do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered in this way? No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. Or those 18 on whom the Tower of Siloam fell and killed them. Do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others who lived in Jerusalem? No, I tell you. But unless you repent, you'll all likewise perish. And he told this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. And he said to the vine dresser, look, for these 3 years now, I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and have found none. Cut it down. Why should it use up the ground? And he answered him, sir, let it alone this year also until I dig around it and put on manure. Then if it should bear fruit next year, well and good. But if not, you can cut it down. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets.
But now in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son.
Thank you. mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Catharsis is a New Age sort of word. It means a release from deep-seated emotion, guilt, angst. It usually means a self-cleansing, and that requires works, a proper context, perhaps even a retreat or escape. It's all about us. But the problem we have is not with our environment or the people around us. Sin is a me problem before God. Christ cleanses us from all sin. But it is entirely his action. He does not do it with a wave of the hand. The Lord does not dismiss wrongdoing. He does not minimize it or overlook it. Rather, Jesus in flesh and blood, like us, took hold of it, making it his own, taking it off of us. And he offered a once-for-all holy sacrifice for sinners. Not a small bit, but everything. His entire body to God the Father to make up for all wrongdoing. The blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us. His Son cleanses us from all sin. Sin is not something that we can forgive ourselves for. Every transgression is against God. We cannot get rid of sin any more than we can climb out of our own skin. Instead, Christ does not tell us to run away from ourselves and our past. He applies his righteousness to it through the verdict of the gospel. It's applied to your account. And so we are not to hurt ourselves or others in the search for a feeling of newness or cleanness. That is sin too. To continue to put ourselves first over God's eternal law and over loving our neighbor who is near us. So we have the bold confession of Scripture. The blood of our God speaks us righteous. Even when our hearts scream guilty, guilty, guilty. We read in the Old Testament about the sacrificial blood. For the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it for you on the altar to make atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes atonement by the life. Our Lord's blood, meaning his entire life, was exchanged for you. And in his holy death, under the world's guilt. And so all God's wrath is appeased. It is ended in Jesus' blood, shed for you. Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man against whom the Lord counts no iniquity. So Christians do not bury their sin. They don't hide it or run away from it. No, we proclaim ourselves to be sinners through and through, better than no one else on earth. For the Spirit moves us to give our sin to God, to be open about our guilt before the Father, because we have the promise. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. This is not self-forgiveness. You cannot mess it up. It is a real cleansing in heaven before the Father. So you are clean. Your transgressions have already been put to death in Jesus through his life-giving blood. So your guilt is removed. You have the power of the Son's blood which covers you. There is no sin or wickedness our Lord's blood cannot forgive. It cleanses the whole person. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So do not live in fear, but confess your sins to God. believe that his blood is for real sinners. It is yours in faith. For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. And that means his righteousness is now your own. The blood of Christ is for you. And this faith we are baptized into does not live in regret or judgment. We live free in Christ. His forgiveness cleanses us so that we are clean before the Father. We are not held back by past sins, by human judgments. We walk in the light of Christ. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. And walking is not just thinking or talking. We actually live in the light, living repentant lives under God in this world. That means turning from sin, resisting the lust of the flesh and Satan. We know that everyone who has been born of God does not keep on sinning, but he who was born of God protects him, and the evil one does not touch him. Our walk in Christ impacts how we treat one another. We are not to let sin, division, or disagreement win the day. That is not what the blood of Christ says. It speaks peace through God's word. So be ready to forgive your neighbor who sins against you, just as God forgives you faithfully. We get to be merciful as our Lord continues to be merciful to us. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more. So we are not afraid of sin or when we do something bad, or not to seek to cover it up. We don't hide from God in his grace and shame. Whoever conceals his transgressions will not prosper, but he who confesses, who speaks and forsakes them, will obtain mercy. We admit our sin because the forgiveness of sins is better and stronger than all the evil in this world. Christ, the one crucified, is our peace and cleanness. Rest in his victory for you. So do not indulge in sin, but do not fear it either. Do not give it power. It has been put to death. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another that you also may be healed. We live in the word of Jesus, which cleanses us. Our sins are not counted against God's holy ones. Every believer is considered righteous by God himself, for we are truly cleansed. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. You may stand for the Magnificat.
He has freed me.
Please stand. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. For President Harrison and President Snow, for all pastors in Christ, for all servants of the church, for all the people, let us pray to the Lord. For our president and all public servants, for our government and those who protect us, that they may be upheld and strengthened in every good deed, let us pray to the Lord. For those who work to bring peace, justice, health, and protection in this and every place, let us pray to the Lord. For those who bring offerings, for those who do good works at Zion, those who toil, those who sing, and all the people here present who wait from the Lord great and abundant mercy, let us pray to the Lord. For favorable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, and danger, and need, let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful who have gone before us and are with Christ, let us give thanks to the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our Lord. O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. The Almighty and Merciful Lord, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you.
Amen.